Esse é o caso do Dream Theater, quinteto de Nova York que desembarcou no Brasil após as gravações de Falling into Infinity, o seu mais novo álbum. Na última quinta e sexta-feira, o grupo esteve se apresentando no Aramaçã, em Santo André. Para quem acha que o heavy metal morreu, um detalhe, a casa estava lotada. A gente esteve por lá conversando com eles sobre o novo álbum e o futuro do metal.
Our whole reason coming down here was just, it was more an introductory tour. It's not like we're actually promoting at this point Falling into Infinity, which is our latest release. This is more or less to come down here and, you know, give the people a live show from Dream Theater, and then at a later date come down, maybe back in 98, and play some of the new material.
I think the new album is very groove-oriented. It's our most groove-oriented album. It's new, and it's completely different from anything we've done. I think it's just an evolution that we've gone through up until this point over playing 10 years with each other.
It's not techno or industrial, if that's what you mean. It's got elements of it, just like it has elements of anything else. The song New Millennium has a industrial type section.
There's like a little bit of Nine Inch Nails, as Mike was saying, on that song, but I don't think we're gonna be like sequencing what you were talking about.
The metal scene is, I don't know, it's like almost non-existent, really. I mean, the metal bands that are there, like Pantera or what have you, are almost going back underground, you know, because even the high-profile metal bands like Metallica, Megadeth or whatever, they're very different sounding, you know. They're more alternative than metal. The problem in America is the styles and the trends are constantly changing from day to day, from month to month. And the minute you try to hone in on one of those trends and try to sound like it and jump on that bandwagon, the next thing you know, by the time your album is out, the trend's going to be changed. So the only way to really have any longevity in this day and age is just this, to forget about what's going on out there and do what you want to do.
Esse programa, aliás, hoje tem entrevista com o Dream Theater. Teremos aí convidados especiais desse programa. Vão estar falando agora no começo do programa exatamente sobre o último e mais recente álbum da banda. Na sequência, a gente vai ver duas bandas de resposta absoluta. Primeiro, Judas Priest com Brick in the Law, enquanto aguardamos aí Jugulator, novo álbum com Tim Ripper Owens no vocal. E na sequência, CDC, a banda do coração. Por hora, Dream Theater, sejam bem-vindos a todos.
Talk about the new album, Falling to Infinity. I'd like to know, is it different from the rest, or?
It's exactly the same. We actually just took the exact CD master of Awake and just put a new cover on it and changed the song titles.
Just the lyrics, or?
Yeah, right. Yeah.
You changed the lyrics?
No, actually the lyrics are the same too. Different titles.
What can you tell about this, musically talking?
Well, this time around we had Kevin Shirley producing the record, and the style in which we recorded it was a lot different than we normally do. We recorded one song at a time, really kind of focused in on each song. And also, this is our first full-length album with Derek playing and writing with us, so his influence has brought some new things into the band. And I think those are the main differences. You know, other than that, it's just the natural progression of where we are as musicians and songwriters, and we're really psyched about it.
You said that you recorded one song, like you did like drums, bass, and you finished the song and then you start the other one.
Yeah, I mean, so we did, sometimes we would be working on a couple of songs at the same time, but we actually would record during the week, and then on the weekends Kevin Shirley would go in and actually mix the song, and it would be mastered on the Monday morning, and that's how we did it. So we were really able to kind of zone in on each song individually, and So there's a real dynamic character, you know, that kind of goes throughout the album.
Perguntei para eles o seguinte: por que eles sempre utilizam quase o tempo total de um CD, ou seja, 75 minutos de música? Será que alguém hoje em dia ainda ouve um disco inteiro de 75 minutos? Mais de uma hora de música na sequência. Veja agora a resposta deles. Vai lá, Dream Theater.
People nowadays, they listen to a whole album, like to the 75 minutes, because I think that most part just listen to one or two songs and...
Well, hopefully in our case they do, or else they're really not going to catch the essence of Dream Theater.
Oh, you think I'd know this by now, right?
The singer doesn't know how to use a microphone.
I thought my voice carried.
Hey. My voice is so powerful, I have to have the mic back here.
But, you know, I mean, definitely with our kind of music and that, and it's just like Mike was saying earlier, I mean, you can't listen to one song in the album and go, oh, yeah, I know what kind of band that is. It's not. It's a whole kind of journey kind of situation with the music that's incorporated on one album, you know? It's very diverse.
It's very diverse. And songs are very long. There are some very long songs. Why that? Do you think it's a good point or...
Well, actually, we discovered that you get paid for the length of music.
So you got some 22 minutes, you get well paid.
We just make more money that way. Yeah, I think that the way that we write, a lot of times there's no real structure going into a song, so it's kind of like we don't really have. I mean, sometimes we do have a beginning and an end, but for the most part, we don't really have an end, and we just kind of write in what we like to call stream of consciousness, where it's just kind of whatever happens, the arrangement develops as we're in there. And I think as a result, I mean, before you know it, you know, 7 minutes have passed and we're still on the second verse. So, you know, the songs that are shorter are I think written with a conscious form in mind, and this way you have like parameters that you're working with. And you kind of can keep the time down.
Mean, não esqueça, daqui a pouquinho vou mostrar Dream Theater, vá.
You dream a festival, because your concerts, like, Dream Theater gigs last for 2.5 hours, yeah. 3 hours. How do you do in a festival that you have, you must play like 45 minutes and...
We knock off some of the other bands. We get them knocked off and then we take their time slots.
Actually, originally, the reason we're here is we were originally asked to do the Monsters of Rock this year before it was canceled. And we were very excited, of course, to come to South America because we've never been here. But it was kind of unsatisfying in the fact that the people's first impression of us would be this 40-minute set. And for us, that's like two songs, you know. So, you know, it kind of worked out well that ended up getting canceled and we were able to come to do our own shows. So everybody's first impression of us is to actually see, you know, what Dream Theater is all about and see the full 2.5 hour shows and make up for lost time, make up for all the years that we hadn't been able to come here.
That's it. Your thing. Was it difficult?
Yeah, it was real difficult because I think we were really looking for a very specific thing. And the problems that we had were that, you know, we wanted somebody that had a lot of range and a strong voice and had a character and a personality to their voice and was able to add something to our music that was... you know, that was going to be a main part of our sound. And there were some guys that had some pretty good voices, but, you know, then the other thing was we wanted to stick to a certain sort of look and image, and we never kind of got the, you know, the best of both.
Image and the technique.
Yeah, and we needed somebody that was real musical because the style was very progressive, and unfortunately, James LaBrie came along and had all those qualities that we were looking for. And he was into the band and, you know, it worked out.
Sentiram o drama então na entrevistinha? Sentiram só o japonês ali do lado, o baixista, aliás, toca muito, o cara tá completamente no além.
Graphic stuff and lies and people that are betrayed, why that? What happened in the band at that time for you to write this kind of lyrics? Like in Awake and Images and Words, they are very strong lyrics.
I think it's always like that. I mean, you're going to write about what you're living through. I think each one of our albums, if you were to break down the lyrics, they represent, you know, the period leading up to the release of that record, for the most part. You know, that's a general statement. But one other good thing is, about the way that this band writes is that everybody writes the lyrics. So even though musically we have a very collective writing where everybody's putting in the ideas. When it comes to the lyrics, it's a very individual style for each particular song because one person is getting to, you know, express their ideas and do it in different ways. I mean, my lyrics are very different from John's or from James's or from John's. You know, all of our lyrics have a very different style, different voices, different ideas.
MTV é sua casa. Assista agora Presente MTV.